Hello students, in this video we are going to start solving lesson work workbook exercises from exercise number 12. So let's go ahead and first understand about make the questions. Befragen. As you already know, there are two types of questions. First is Befragen, that is WH question, and the second is yes no question. If the answer is starting with yes or nein, ja or nein, then definitely you will form yes no question. And if the answer is specifically given, then you need to form WH question. In case of yes no question and WH question, the verb position differs. In WH question, the verb comes at second position, whereas in yes no question, the verb comes at first position. So let's understand first which are the Befragen. Most of the Befragen you must be knowing. We are just revising it. Where means who, when, to or for whom, woher is from where, was is what, wann means when, wie lange how long, wie is how or what. Most of the time wie's meaning is how, wie gets, wie war der Film. But wie's meaning is what only in case of heißen, wie heißt du, Adresse, wie ist deine Adresse, telephone number or handy number, wie ist deine handy number, Vorname, wie ist dein Vorname, wie ist dein Nachname, Vorname is first name, Nachname is surname, wie ist deine email Adresse. So in the cases which I have given in the bracket, for those cases, wie means what. Otherwise, we means how. Welche means which. When means whom. Wo means where. Wohin means to where. Warum means why. Wie viel Uhr means at what time. Whenever specific timing is have to be told. Wie viel Uhr begin their film. So the film begins at 7 o'clock, for example. So specific timing is given. Wie oft is how often. Then we feel is how much, we feel is how many, and seit wann means since when. So these are the WH questions. According to meaning, you need to decide which WH question can be used to form the question. Is this clear? Now let's solve the exercise based on make the question. It is Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 86. Aufgabe Nummer 12, Bilderfragen. Before we start the exercise, Bilderfragen, I would like to revise few things. First thing, you will check whether the answer is starting with ja or nein. If yes, you will form yes no question. If the answer is not starting with ja or nein, you will form a WH question. If you are forming yes no question, you have to put the verb at the first place. In WH question, the verb goes at second place. If in the answer ish is given, you have to make the question with capital C or du. Accordingly, you need to conjugate the verb. If in the answer wer is given, then you have to make the question with ear. For third person, there is no change. Okay? Is it clear? So while solving this exercise, first you need to know the meaning of the sentence. Whatever is the underlying part, for that part you are going to form the question, and you have to form the question grammatically correct. So let's see few examples. A. This is meine Freundin Sonia. This is my friend Sonia. So we have want to have the answer for meine Freundin Sonia. So naturally the question will be, who is this? For who, WH question is where, so where is thus. Clear? Now let's see the B1. Jedes Zimmer in der Wohnung hat zwei Türen. Every room in the house has two doors. So in English, naturally, we will make how many doors has every room in the house. Similar like English, in German also, how many doors. Door should come as a first position only, and then has should come. So we feel a Turin hat jedes Zimmer in der Wohnung. In case of we feel and we feel a, you have to remember that noun always comes at the first place. So we feel a Turin hat jedes Zimmer in der Wohnung. Now let's see C1. Elisabeth und Sylvia gehen zweimal in der Woche schwimmen. Zweimal in der Woche. They both go for swimming twice in a week. Whenever this is shown twice, thrice, or four times, five times, then the question automatically comes, how often do they go? And for how often, the WH question is we oft. We have to put the WH question at the beginning, that is we oft. Then we have to use the verb, that is gehen. Then the subject will come, Elizabeth and Sylvia, and then Schwimmen will go at the end of the sentence. So here automatically the question is we oft gehen Elizabeth und Sylvia Schwimmen. Remember first WH question, then verb, then subject, then whatever is left. Klar? Aufgabe D. Im Sommer machen die Freunde eine Reise in die Türkei. In summer, the friends go for a journey or trip in the Turkey. So when do they go? For when the word is one, the same way now. One will come at the first place, then verb, that is machen. Then the subject is die Freunde and the remaining part. So one machen die Freunde eine Reise in die Türkei. I hope that how to make the questions is clear to you. We'll discuss the answers of the remaining questions in our live class. On the next page, means Aufgabe Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 6 und 8, the remaining part of the make the questions is there from M to V. These are also make the questions. So solve the whole exercise Aufgabe 12 and then we will discuss the answers of the same in our live class. Now the next topic is perfect. Before we start solving perfect exercises, let's understand what is perfect. There are two types of past tense in German language. One is perfect and one is Prätertum. We have already seen the Prätertum form of haben and sein. Basically, perfect is used for recent past. Whatever things has happened few years ago, few months ago, few weeks ago, always for that the perfect is used. Perfect is used more often in the speaking language. Whereas Prätertum is used for remote past. For example, in the fairy tales, in history books, or in fables, or whenever the world war history or something is explained, or the newspaper articles also sometimes. It is more formal language, that is the Prätertum. It is used more in written form. So now let's understand first how perfect form is made. Perfect tense is formed by auxiliary verb and the past tense form of the verb. Now here auxiliary verb is haben or sein. That comes at second position or first position, wherever the verb is in the original sentence. And the perfect form, that is the past tense form of the verb, goes at the end of the sentence. Now let's understand first when to use haben and when to use sein. Sein is used whenever there is a change of movement, state or action. Whenever there is a change from one point to another point, from one state to another state, that is always sein. For example, fahren, reisen, gehen, einsteigen, to climb in the bus or railway. Sterben is to die, change of state. So these are the verbs, they always take sein as an auxiliary verb. Ausnahmen, but there are definitely exceptions for the same. The sein itself, that is to be, passieren is to happen and bleiben is to stay. These three verbs don't show any change in movement, state or action. Still, these verbs take always sein as an auxiliary verb. And for rest of the verbs, haben is used as an auxiliary verb. Now let's understand how to form past tense form. Ich lerne Deutsch. I learn German. Here lernen is the verb which is not showing any change in movement, state or action. So that lernen will take haben naturally. Wherever is the position of lernen? For example, here lernen is put at second place. So you will also use the haben. You will conjugate haben according to the subject and put at the second place. So here it will be Ich habe Deutsch gelernt. And gelernt is the past tense form of haben, that past tense form of lernen that will go at the end of the sentence. Now one more sentence is Ich fahre nach Delhi. I travel to Delhi. Here fahren shows the change in movement, state or action. So here in this case, it will take sein as an auxiliary verb. So you have to conjugate sein according to the subject. Here subject is Ich. So Ich bin nach Delhi gefahren. Gefahren is the past tense form of fahren. So always remember that sein or haben will come either at first place or second place, wherever the verb is originally in the sentence, and the past tense form will go at the end of the sentence. Is it clear? Now we will move ahead and we will see how to make the perfect form, how to form the past tense form, because there are different rules to make the past tense form. First rule is GE plus T. You already know this. We are just revising this. Lernen, GE is added at the beginning and EN is removed and T is added. Gelernt. Machen, gemacht. So GE plus T is the first rule. Then GE plus EN. GE plus EN means GE is put at the beginning and no change in the verb. For example, fahren, gefahren. Kommen, gekommen. So no change, only GE is added in the beginning. Then the verbs which begin with BE, ER, ENT, ZER, VR, never take GE at the beginning. Just keep this mind. Whenever the verbs begin with BE, ER, ENT, ZER, VER, they never take GE. For example, bekommen remains bekommen itself. Verkaufen, verkauft. Zerbrechen, zerbrochen. So never GE is taken. That's why you can see the difference. Kommen, it is gekommen. But bekommen remains bekommen itself because GE won't be added at the beginning. Now the next rule is verbs ending with IERN. The verbs which end with IERN always take T at the end. And GE is not added at the beginning. Telefonieren, telefoniert. Gratulieren, gratuliert. No GE at the beginning, only T at the end. Okay. In case of separable verbs, always GE comes between the prefix and verb. GE always comes between prefix and verb. For example, einladen, eingeladen. Uncommon. Prefix is an, verb is common, angekommen. Zumachen, to close, zugemacht. And some verbs undergo absolute change while making past tense form. Those you have to learn by heart. For example, gehen, gegangen, werden, geworden, bleiben, geblieben. These verbs you have to remember as it is. Most of the times you need to remember perfect form. So practice perfect more. Learn past tense form. By practice, you will start understanding where to use GE, where not to use GE, and it will be helpful for you. I hope that the perfect is clear to you. Now, let's move ahead with the exercises. Now, Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 7 und 80. Aufgabe 13. This is the exercise 13. And this is the simple. Here, you are not supposed to make any perfect form. Just you have to ordner suit. Just you have to match the pair. They have already given the sentences in perfect only. But you have to match the pair. So you do this exercise as a homework. We will discuss the answers of the same in your live class. And in the next video, we will do more exercises of perfect. Is this clear? Thank you.